Okay, now we will discuss concept of the slowly changing dimension in SSIS. What we have slowly changing dimension, we are having some practical concept and few concepts are related to the theory. There is conflict between theoretical concept and practical concept. We will check it over here, the practical concept. We already discussed concept of the theoretically in the class. What we have, when we see that we are having slowly changing dimension, and slowly changing dimension, let me see that we are having one source is available. We are creating the new package over here, right click and new package. Now here we are having the new package is available. We are having the source data is available, and source data we are having the table is available. We already created it over here. The name of table is here. Let we are having EMP is the name of the table is available. That is available in the source ABC, right? We already executed and we already moved 3 different records to this one table. That is available in the source, and the source name is here ABC database, and over there we are creating one table AB employee, right? Now we see that we want to move this data from the employee table to another table at the destination, and our destination is here. We are selecting the destination database BSE6A. Over there we are creating the table, create table, name of table, employee destination. In this one table, all of the columns are the same, ID, name, address, salary, but we have to mention it over here, start date and end date. If, even if you want to use the column for the flag, we can use it over here. We want to add the column related to the flag, we can use it over here, but we are ignoring it over here at this stage. So start date, we see that when these changes are occur, we are having the different type of the slowly changing dimension. But we see that fixed change, and fixed change we see that no change will be occur. Whenever we are having the source data is there, no change is possible in the source data components. Second one, we are having change value, and change value, change will be occur at the source system, same change will be reflected at the destination systems. And third one, we are having, we have to track the history. If change occur at the source system, we have to insert the new record at the target system or destination system. Our source system contains the 3 different records. We are creating the table over here at the destination system. So for that one, to track the changes, we are using the concept of the start date and end date. When previous date was there and what is the new date is available. Execute it. This one will be, this one table will be created over here at the table BSE6A. But we don't have any record over here in this one table yet. Right? If we check it over here, ABC table. And ABC, we are, whenever we are having table is available, the name of table we are having, that is, just refresh it, emp. So here we are having the, when we execute this one, it says that 3 different records are available at the source. But destination, our destination is here BSE6A. And BSE6A table, if you want to check it over here, table names, execute this one. So where we are having emp is there, just check it out. We do, no, this one, what is the name of table?
Employee destination.
Employee destination, let me check where we are having this one, right click and display it over here. Still now we don't have any record. Over here start date and end date columns we are using the extra, that are not available at the source systems. So whenever we are using it over here, SSIS, very first step, what is, we have to select the source data component. Right, for the source data components, what we have to take the value, there is source data component, okay, first step, we have to use it over here, data flow task, when we double click over here on the data flow task, then we may be able to find it over here, the source data, destination data and data transformation steps. So what we have, a OLEDB destination at, we have to select it over here, OLEDB source, very first step. Okay, when we double click it over here, then move it over here, double click, Now we have to select the source. Check it out. No one for this packing. Click over here the new. What is the source is there? ABC. Right? Click over here. Okay. Table. What is the name of the table? Table name is here EMP. Preview. Records are available. Three different records are here. Data is available over here. Column. Check it. All columns are here. ID, name, salary, address and salary. Okay. Now, we have to move the second step. Second step is we have to use the slowly changing dimension. What? Slowly changing dimension. And common task, we are having the concept of the slowly changing dimension. Drag it and drop it over here. Right? Now, here we have to use from the source data, precedence errors, drop it over here, double click it over here. It display one wizard that is related to the slowly changing dimension wizard. Click it over here. Next. What it say? It said correction manager. That is the ABC. What we are having? We have to select a dimension table and keys. Which one? Should be our table should be here. No, we don't want to take it over here ABC. Which one we want to take it over here now? We want to move data from the ABC to BSC6A. So we see that over here BSC6A is our destination should be there. Click it over here, okay. And which one table should be here? So table name is here employee destination. Right? When we select the table name, after that one, it will ask from us that we have to select input column, destination column and key type. So over here we must have to select business key or the primary key columns on the basis of which we have to perform the different operations. It is very necessary. We have to select the business key, surrogate key or simply we say data primary key. So we say that ID, that not a key, that ID is a key. Click it over here, select that is the business key. Mean that is the surrogate key or normally we say that is the primary key. Click it over here, next. Right? What we did over here? We select the destination, then table and then very first step we have to select the business key. So which one is the primary key or which one is the surrogate key, we have to use it over here as the business key. Click over here, next. Now here you can see that in slowly changing dimension columns, we are having the different options are available. Fixed attribute, select the attribute when the value in the column should not change. Whenever we are having the column is there, column value should not change. If we are having name is there, name value should not be changed. Right? That should be a fixed attribute. So destination column, select the column names that we are having name. Name should be a fixed attribute. Let me say next one, changing attribute. We see that if we are changing the attribute, that is related to the type 1 change over here. We have to overwrite. Existing value will be removed with the new value. Already existing value will be removed. Discard, update it with the new value. So we see that address, let we are considering it over here. We see that we are not taking the history of the address, right? We are just using it over here, address as a changing attribute. Whenever address attribute is there, we will describe the value of the address. Next one, we see that we are having salary. What we say? If anyone want to make the change in the salary in the source system, in that cases, we must track the history related to that one. That was, what was the previous salary and what is the new salary. So we are considering it over here. Salary is the historical attribute. We want to keep track related to the salary attribute. So here let me see that address can be over here the fixed attribute or name can be over here changing attribute. More than one attribute can have the same types can be there. So we are using type 0 for the name. That is a fixed attribute, type 1 for the address, mean we are discarding the previous value with the new value, and for the salary we are using the type 2, and that is we have to keep track of history. Is it clear? Yes. Is it clear? Then we have to click it over here, simply next. And again next. Now, here we have to select this one option use. Start and end date. We are already using the concept of the start and end date. Select it over here. Start date. What we are having? Start date. End date. What that one we are having? The end date column. Already we created over here the new columns. start date and end date, if you remember that one. And the value for this one, so for that one we are selecting it over here, system start times. What is the time of the system? What is the time of that one? Select that one, right? And then click it over here simply on the next button, right? And then click it over here next. If we are using flag over there, then we have to select it over here on the flag. As we didn't use any flag, so for that one we are not considering it over here. For the flag, you say that's a status value. Is status current status? For that one, you can use the data a bit, and then you have to select this one, and then status value should be displayed over here. But we didn't use it over here, so no need of that one. Next, and click it over here on the finish. Wait, when we do it over here, it automatically separate this one, slowly changing. For that one, historical data, for the infer attribute, for the changing attributes, all the attribute will be here, value will be here. So automatically, union, derived, all the operation will be performed over here. At this stage, our target system, destination system, we don't have any data. No, execute this one package. Let's see what will be happened. When we execute the package, what it say? In the source system, we are having the three different records. Data moved, very first time, no data is available, so all the records are inserted over here at the target system. Right? If we check our destination system, what we are having? Employee destination, right click and now it says three different records are available. What is the start date? It displays it over here. Right? Now, next one. We see it, end date, till now we don't have any one. Next step, what we want to do it? We see that we are having the source data is available. And source data BSE, source data name is here ABC. ABC table name was, table name was here EMP, right? What we want to do it over here, we want to update in this one table. Which one value we want to update? Let me see that we want to update the value of the address. Right? We see for the name, we see that we can't update it. If you update it, it will display the error message that you can't. Package will not complete it successfully. If you are making change in the address, previous address was here, Peshawar, for ID 2. What we say? Update. Table name is here, EMP. What we have to do? Set address is equal to, let we are having Islamabad, where what we have ID is equal to 2. Okay, now execute this one. And source system, we make the change over here. What is the change over here? We make the change over here in the address. As we see that address is a which one type? That is related to the type 1 change attribute. Now we want to re-execute this one package. Right? Let's see what will be happened. Right? Just it discard the previous value with the new value. Execute it. It said it previous already data is available at the source to target. So what will be happened? What we are having over here, three different rows are moved from source to target. Slowly change. Now only one row is updating. Change attribute update one row. Over here, we don't have any records over here, but all the other values. Got the point? No new output will be here. Only for the change attribute. Just check it out at the target system. This one is here. Destination system executed. What we have? Okay, we are having addresses here, Islamabad. Got the point? Same. If you want to make the change over here on the salary, let's see what will be happened. Now just when we make the change over here in the address, that is the change value, so it just discard previous value with the new value. No history is maintained over here. And we are having salary, previous value is here 4444. Now we are using 8888. Update at the source. When the value is updated, now again let's see. Just execute this one. again re-execute it, start it. So change will be made over here only for the what we are having historical attribute value, one row, right? Change is made over here for the historical attribute. Now let's see what will be happened over here at the destinations. We make the change over here at the target, sorry, source. Now what will be happened over here at the target? Right click it over here, display it over here. Now let's see. You can see it over here in the employee ID 2. We make the change in the salary over here. The salary is here. Previous was here 4444. For the type 2 change, what it will do? We have to keep track the history. It insert the new record over here. Now the value of the new salary and previous salary, both the values are available over here. Is it clear? So ID value is same over here as well as ID value is same over here in both of these. In this way, we may be able to implement the concept of the slowly changing dimension.
Sir, can I